Now here we are to have a look at an acoustic guitar, and this one is the Tanglewood Nashville Folk guitar. It's, as you can see, a folk guitar size is it's a wee bit smaller than a dreadnought. And you can see I've fitted this one with a preamp, but it comes without preamp. Nicely finished, satin finish overall, very laid back, very thin, and therefore the guitar is very responsive. It's quite a loud guitar. In fact, that was my purpose in buying this particular one. I wanted a loud guitar for choir practice, Bible study groups and so on. And this was actually louder than the dreadnoughts that I had originally been thinking that I would get. So as you can hear, quite a reasonable volume. It's always hard on a video like this to compare one with another. So I have one that I prepared earlier. So just to give you a comparison, this is the Fender parlor guitar, the C100. So yes, you can hear quite a difference in the volume of the two instruments. So back to the Tanglewood. Now, this was a relatively cheap guitar. It's not entry level, but it's kind of one step up from it. And you can see the case behind me that it comes in. It's a very, very good hard case. Now using a plectrum, so you'll see things are louder still. In the construction of the guitar, there's one odd thing about it and one small fault. I have to be honest in all these reviews. The odd thing is that the saddle is much higher than you would normally expect, and yet the action is standard. It's a perfectly acceptable action, but a very high saddle. Now that would tell us that the neck angle is slightly too much, isn't it? Slightly too much. But it's not really a problem at the moment in playing wise. In fact, in the long term, 20 years down the road, if the guitar's still here, and if I'm still here, then guitars like people tend to develop a big belly as they get older, and this part of the guitar usually rises. That means in older guitars you have to put in a lower saddle. Well, in this case, having a high saddle in the first instance, that will actually work to my advantage. So I will never have to actually shave down the wood. I'll just be able to put in a more normal sized saddle as time goes by. Now that was the odd thing. It's not a fault, it's just something slightly different to be aware of. The fault that I found with it, and it sound made it worthwhile actually persevering with it, was that the nut spacing is a little too generous across the strings, which resulted in the first string being right on the edge of the knuckle of the fret, you know, where it starts to turn down. Which led to some buzzing if you weren't careful as you came up the first string. So I took the nut off and basically moved it over a millimetre and shaved off the sticky out bit at the other end, and everything is now fine. But that's maybe just a wee point that Tanglewood might want to have a think about. The machine heads are fine, they're very good. They're open machine heads. Which is not quite fashionable nowadays, but there's nothing wrong with open machine heads. A nice little bit of veneer with the Tanglewood name on the top there. Very smart guitar. Now, performance as we go up the neck. intonation. To be honest, I've heard better intonation-wise, but there again, you're playing folk style. What on earth are you doing up here? You know, I mean, it all happens down in the first five frets, let's face it. And for that purpose, it's a great little guitar. Where you want volume, and you don't want a guitar that's too big, this could be the very guitar.